I represent the United States Department of Veterans Affairs. I'm a veteran myself, retired in 2009. I've got a lot of my colleagues and friends here today, and I'm going to introduce folks as we go along. But if you're a veteran, we've two very important things today. We've got specialists that can enroll you in VA health care that are eligibility specialists that can go over your information, get you signed up today so you can get the health care you earned through your service to our great nation. And we also have a benefits expert from the Veteran Benefits Administration, Mr. Paul Neville, who's also here today. So there's a registration table up front. Just sign your name in. They'll call your name, and you can see our two different specialists, one for healthcare and one for any kind of benefits questions you might have, whether it's filing a claim, questions about GI Bill, et cetera. And all the programs that I point out correlate to one of our program managers that's here from the VA. All right. These are all the things we're going to cover. We're going to talk about your benefits, the different healthcare programs that are available to you. We have a wonderful outpatient clinic that's within a 5-mile drive from here, just around the corner off of 2A. We'll talk about the different support services that are available through the VA. And then I want to point out a couple of key programs, the Springfield Vet Center, our Make the Connection program, and then without leaving today, we want to make sure every veteran has an opportunity to enroll in VA. And then the meet and greet part, that's the easy part. That's the informal part. All our program managers are here. Avail yourselves of the opportunity to ask questions. Okay, so this is the obligatory mission slide for all you vets that have served. You know, we gotta have a mission slide, right? VA is a large organization. It's the second largest federal department in our nation's government after the Department of Defense. And it's the second oldest as well after the Department of Defense. We're divided into three components. Most of the folks that are here today represent the VHA side, which is the Veterans Health Administration. Mr. Paul Neville is here, and he's from VBA, the Veterans Benefits Administration. And you'd like to think you don't need to think about it now, especially for your young guys, but it's always good to know that there's a National Cemetery Administration to perpetuate our memory with our loved ones and our family members. May not be important to you now, but it's good to know and understand that those are benefits for you as well. So those are the three areas under the VA. Our mission is an enduring one. Best way to capture what we do goes back to 1865 in March with the second inaugural address from President Lincoln, where the famous words, "To care for him who shall have borne the battle and for his widow and his orphan." Today we'd like to say to care for him and her, because it's very important that our women veterans know that the VA is there for them as well with great programs and services. But that mission, that core value that we've had as a VA exists today with the two key words, to care. And everyone that represents the VA, at the end of the day, everything is about, have we nurtured, have we advocated for you as a veteran, have we done what we can to get you the information we need, which is really why we're here today. And so I'd also like to say that the running theme throughout this is that our job in the VA is only possible, what we try to achieve each and every day is only possible through a lot of collaboration. And a lot of it is you're going to see here today. You know, starting first of all with this college, GCC is making a name for itself for the programs and services and benefits it provides to veterans. That starts all the way from the top with your president, Mr. Pura, all the way down through the administration. So with Kevin and Michael Lewis too, you guys are wonderful in reaching out to us, and it's been a great relationship. And you know, we're just down the street. If you need anything from us, we're a phone call, an email away, and we'll be up here. So we want you to know that. On the state side, way in the back there, I'll let John Beaton. He's from the Soldier's Home down in Holyoke, because that's another part of this, is our state services. Just kind of a show of hands for folks, how many of you have your home of record from Massachusetts? Your home of record, so you're from Massachusetts. when you served, how often did we get kind of that side comment about, oh, you're from Massachusetts, you know, and a good place to be a veteran? I heard that when I was on active duty, and I always corrected them. No, we have the best programs and services of any state, and the Commonwealth prides itself on that. Coleman Nee, the Secretary of Veterans Services, and that runs through. We're the only state in the nation that I'm aware of that has community veteran service agents, and they're a wonderful resource. We got Mark Fitzpatrick here. Mark, if you want to, hey Mark, if you want to wave, stand up. Mark Fitzpatrick represents the Central Franklin County Veterans Services Office, Turner's Falls, Montague, and then his colleague Charlie Lovin helps us out in Greenfield too. So wonderful resources for you all to know about. Lots of opportunities for the VA right now. For many of you, you need to know that there are programs and services. If you've returned from combat from Afghanistan or Iraq, or you're an older veteran in Korea and Vietnam, there's programs specifically for you that talks to you as a veteran. We're going to talk a little bit about how we've individualized our services and programs. But we have our OEF, OIF, OND programs. For those of you that don't know those acronyms, OEF, Operation Enduring Freedom, Afghanistan. OIF, Operation Iraqi Freedom, Iraq, of course, and Operation New Dawn, which is the new code operational name from 2010, when operations, as you guys know, transitioned over to more of a stabilization operation, so hence the code word Operation New Dawn, but Iraq. Like everything in healthcare, tremendous changes in healthcare across our nation, and the VA is changing with those trends as well. So you're going to see more in VA on healthcare in the home, more services for the veterans, telehealth programs, things like that are rapidly evolving and expanding. Everything now is about patient-centered care, and that's going to be more important as even younger veterans than the guys out here, that generation comes up, they want individualized care plans, and there's more focus on that now, patient-centered care. And then we're a growing healthcare system, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that here shortly. But 22 million veterans that are in VA, 8.3 million are in healthcare, and that's our numbers. The reason why I put those numbers up, just to recognize that we're a huge system. We're the largest integrated healthcare system in the United States, the largest out of any healthcare system in the United States. And that means that, you know, you can go anywhere in the nation, and there's a VA clinic, a VA center where you can find care. All right, Paul's got a room in the back, and if he were here right now, but he's already taking veterans to work with them on an individual basis. But here right now, he'd say this is his area of expertise. Okay, what he does not do is get you enrolled in VA healthcare. He won't talk about healthcare specifics, but his areas are these things on this slide. So I'm not going to take a lot of time. But if you have a question about any of these particular areas, see Ms. Joyce Frederick. She's in the back. Joyce, wave, and Joyce will get you on a sign-in sheet. And then Paul's coming back out and one at a time going in so you can have dedicated time with him to talk about your past history, anything you want to go over with him. Regional healthcare system. For the Army guys, kind of like if you're in Europe and you've got United States Army Europe and you have V Corps, or if you're Air Force, you know, you got United States Air Forces in Europe and you got Third Air Force. Kind of like for us, for the VA, you've got regional systems throughout the country. Our major command, if you will, is the VA New England Healthcare System. It's headquartered out of Bedford in Eastern Mass, and our specific region, our numbered Air Force, or our Corps, if you will, is VA Central Western Mass. And we recently expanded in October. We've got clinics now in Worcester and Fitchburg, and we're also located in Springfield. And just around the corner in Munson Street in the Greenfield Corporate Center, we have our outpatient clinic, and we're also located in Pittsfield. So three locations in Western Mass and two in Central Mass. Why did we do that? Well, before, Fitchburg and Worcester were located with Boston and Bedford in Eastern Mass, and from focus groups and feedback we got from veterans aren't so crazy about driving into Jamaica Plain or West Roxbury for their care. So over time, We're looking at having more specialized care in Central and Western Mass, so we can have centers of excellence for folks to go for specialty care instead of having to drive into Boston. It's going to take some time, though, and for the foreseeable future, if you need acute, chronic, specialized care, yeah, you'll get referred within a greater VA system. But for most, 90% of your health care, you can be seen right here at an outpatient clinic or down in Northampton. All right. I think we've got, is Mr. Goodwin here? Tom? There, you're right in front. Hi, sir. Mr. Goodwin is a volunteer with the outpatient clinic going on 2,000 plus hours, I think, over 2,000 hours. A veteran. We've got a wonderful pool of about 300 volunteers throughout our VA system. Most are veterans themselves, continue to give back and serve our country. Tom volunteers out of the Greenfield outpatient clinic. 90% of what you need can be serviced at the clinic. It's kind of like your family doctor is right here at the outpatient clinic. If you need a referral, if it's, say, mental health or psychiatric, often it'll be Northampton. If you need anything that's surgical, Boston or perhaps West Haven, Connecticut. So it's not a far distance. Kind of similar to if you went to Bay State, they might need to refer you to Beth Israel, Mass General, or if you're at Cooley Dickinson in Northampton, same kind of thing. But for our veterans, your first place you want to go is the outpatient clinic. That's where your primary care provider is going to be, and you see the programs and services there. Tom, do you want to mention about our physicians and our clinical staff?
The Greenfield Clinic, two doctors, two nurses, then a psychiatrist 3 days a week, a social worker for making life a little bit easier to live a couple of days a week, another social worker to work on particular programs like transportation for individuals. That's one-on-one. There's a nutritionist there every Tuesday, and then once a month you have a respiratory clinic, a diabetes clinic. What did I miss? I'm forever seeing these strange people come up here from Northampton and walk into the clinic and be there all day long. There are four volunteers, all from the Disabled American Veterans Chapter 33 right here in Greenfield. I'm the only one who lives in Greenfield. But we do our very best to support the VA clinic here in Greenfield, and we think a lot of it. And that's why after 22 years plus service of the United States Army, I'm trying to give something back to the VA that's cared for me. And they do care for me, and they care for all the vets. And that's the important thing. And that clinic in Greenfield is probably the best clinic of the Northampton Hospital. It's one of the top 20 in the country. And it's by patient satisfaction, not because I say so. But it's a good place. It's modern, it's in the Greenfield Corporate Center location, not hard to find. And the offices are fairly modern. It was opened in the summer of 2006. Last time we had a fair to celebrate 5 years, we gained 50 new patients. So it's a going concern. And the system is connected as long as electricity doesn't go out.
It's known to happen occasionally with an ice storm or such. Thank you, Tom. I didn't pay Tom for that paid political advertisement. It was perfect, but that just tells you it's a family within the VA. We're veterans. We understand what it's to serve. Or if you're a professional that's been in the VA, we have folks that have been in the VA system serving 20, 30 plus years. We understand veterans. You know, as you guys study branding and marketing and positioning, our position is we understand veterans unlike any other healthcare system in the country. And if it ain't right, we're gonna fix it. So the folks that are here represented today includes volunteers like Tom, and wonderful to have him on our team. 22 years of service, fantastic. Where Tom goes, he's getting a coffee now, but it's gonna. Okay. So that's your outpatient clinic. I'm going to go back really quick because I forgot to point out the 1-800 numbers that's on here. That's an extremely important number that you write down and have on your wall, in your room, or on the magnet in your refrigerator. That's our call center number, and that's the one-stop shop number for all our healthcare services and programs within our service area in Central and Western Mass. You'll get to a call center that's manned by 11 healthcare specialists, including RNs, health techs, and they're immediately going to be able to find out, okay, who do you need to talk to, refer you to primary care if necessary, kind of whittle through exactly what you need. And we're one of the best in New England with our access times. Within, I think it's 22 seconds now, you'll get somebody on the phone. And then from there, they'll put you in touch with another person to get all your needs. But for appointments, prescription referrals, that's the number that you want. That's your first entry point into the VA for telephone care. And as Tom mentioned, the Greenfield Clinic just got like one of the top 20 across the nation for its access, for appointments, for the time to schedule an appointment and time that you get in, and for your care. So it's just, you guys got a wonderful a system of care here in Franklin County. Just down the road in 91, you have the Springfield Vet Center, but they serve all of Western Mass. What you see there is their mobile vet center. It's a 35-foot RV, but they have come up here before. They do get around throughout all the three counties in Western Mass. But the key thing I want you to know about the Springfield Vet Center is that center started with Congress in the late 70s after it was determined that there is a great need for our Vietnam veterans to go in without having to bring in any of their medical records, without having the stigma of having a government agency looking at your information and background, and be able to go in and get counseling services on the spot, no questions asked. And that care still exists today for all veterans of any armed hostility, to include Iraq, Afghanistan. So if you served and you bring your DD-214 into the Springfield Vet Center in the North End in Springfield, they will see you. They prefer that you get an appointment, but they'll see you that day. And they serve the veteran and his family, the significant other, spouse, girlfriend, boyfriend. That's what they're there for, bereavement counseling. I know from experience, from having colleagues at another VA center in another part of the country, where we sent soldiers, sailors, and airmen over to the vet center to get bereavement counseling after a comrade died in Iraq. So I know it works. It's a great program. It's one that's very much you need to be aware of for other veterans that are friends and neighbors. All right, now I'm going to quickly go through all our different support services and programs. So Tom Goodwin mentioned about the Greenfield Outpatient Clinic, your docs, your primary care physicians, your LPNs, your RNs, but, you know, kind of holding all that up are all the plethora of support services and programs. So, you know, kind of the logistics side to the house, all these other programs. The RNs and the docs are all, they're fantastic, but they're only as good as the support programs that are available to them. And we have programs that fit individual needs throughout the VA. So these are the ones I'm going to touch upon quickly and briefly. For our OEF, OIF, OND program, we have Ms. Sheila Davies. Sheila, if you just want to stand. And so Sheila's here and her team's here. If you have any questions on, if you're a returning combat veteran from Iraq and Afghanistan, you have 5 years from the time that you separated from active duty for VA health care, for a service-connected disability. Once you're locked into the system, you're in. Really, really important that our returning combat veterans know about this program, these services. Cost-free care for combat-related conditions. And from Sheila's team, from a case management perspective, they offer all the other different programs, from employment counseling, education. I think at any given time we have about 90 or so veterans that have severe injuries or PTSD or trauma that they've experienced from their active duty time, where Sheila's team provides all the wraparound services for them, make sure that they're transitioning as well as they possibly can. So definitely take time to ask about those programs with Sheila. If not for yourself, you may, I know to a large extent, looking at Kevin and you guys up front, I'm preaching in a choir, because you know about these programs, you understand them. For some of the folks that are out in the audience and all, if you got a family member or a neighbor that's returned from Iraq, it's amazing to me that we still have some veterans that aren't aware of these programs and services, which is the reason why we're here today. From our Women's Veterans Health Program, we have Ms. Kim Adams, who's an RN, former Army nurse. Sheila's former Army as well, and a Greenfield Community College alum, I should say. And so Kim's program is focused on women's health care, and that is expanding every day, and there's more programs and more services for our women's veterans health programs. The population is growing all the time. You know, I think as we were leaving active duty, I think it was about 5-6%. Now we're up to 8% of the active duty population are women veterans. That population is going to grow. You see in the news that there's more relaxation of restrictions for women to serve in combat. They are coming back from combat zones where they have served and have been exposed to the same elements and the same small arms fire, mortars, etc., and are coming back with the same symptoms with PTSD and mental health trauma that our male veterans and colleagues are undergoing. So it's incumbent that we're providing different kind of care, because it's a different gender, different species. As I see my wife every morning, she reminds me she's connected in a different way. So we've got folks like Kim that can connect in a different way than I can as a male, or maybe a doc or provider can. So if we don't have it in Northampton or Boston, there's a place and there's a location within the VA system for specialty care. But I will tell you a couple of centers of excellence. Groundbreaking research, wonderful programs in West Haven, Connecticut, just down 91, where they do incredible work with blind rehabilitation with the millions of veterans out there that have some form or manner of disability as it applies to vision. Good for you all to know about that. Just down the road, down 91. Boston, Bedford are doing wonderful research in traumatic brain injury, stuff that's leading the VA and leading the country with research. Brain scanning, things in Bedford right now that the NFL is looking to as far as how we're doing it in the VA, because as we're seeing guys on the playing field on the NFL with concuss and looking at brain injury, they're probably going to have to look at for the rest of their lives. The stuff that they're learning from the VA, from our veterans that are coming back from the war, that's the stuff that private health care is learning from, and that's all right here in New England. New England leads the country in the VA in the number of research dollars that are coming in. Our system has an active affiliation with University of Massachusetts Medical School in Worcester, and we're doing all sorts of research collaboration with the folks out there. Right now, University of Massachusetts is working with us to create an app for PTSD and for texting, for you to have almost like a virtual avatar to work through your challenges and anything you're going, because we found from focus groups with the younger vets, that's what they want. They don't want to necessarily come in and talk to a human being. They'd rather do it from their handheld device. So we're working with UMass right now to come up with that. This is something that would be for the entire nation. But there's other programs like that we're working on. So there's all sorts of different specialty care, specialty services. We lead the nation with prosthetics, with the research that we're doing with prosthetics. An article recently in the Houston Chronicle reported that an Army Special Forces veteran, Randy Tipton, became the first VA patient in the nation to receive the iWalk Power Foot, a robotic foot that represents a groundbreaking advance in prosthetic technology made possible by millions of dollars that the U.S. government has poured into research to rebuild service members who have lost limbs in Iraq and Afghanistan. The soldier demonstrated the device. He said, the power foot represents a quantum leap. He said, this is unbelievable. Never thought it would be possible for me to use and have motion again, filling the space of where the limb used to be. It replicates my Achilles tendon, ankle, and calf muscle. It's amazing what our nation can provide in the services, all within the VA system. Caregiver support, kind of like I was saying at the beginning with telehealth and care programs and services in your home, caregiver support right now is another expanding, growing program. If you have chronic medical conditions, you want to have a family provider for you to provide for you 24/7, and for any of you that have helped a family member, immediate family member, you know how hard that can be. There are programs to help you out. Programs for you as the caregiver, not to mention the programs for you as the veteran. Respite services to give you a break, all that's available for you. There's some pretty strict eligibility requirements for that. You know, I mean, if you got the flu, this is not the program, right? But if you've got, no kidding, chronic, severe, acute medical conditions, and you want to be seen and cared for in your home with a loved one, significant other, family member, the VA has programs and services for you for that. And that is going to be very much an expanded program over the years. Not something that maybe you're thinking about now, but I tell you what, it's good to know about these programs. At some point for geriatric extended care, we're all going to need some help and assistance. There's long-term care for chronically ill. We've got a wonderful home-based primary care program, similar to, if you're familiar with VNA, with Visiting Nurses Association, very similar to that. But institutional, non-institutional programs for homebound veterans, and a wonderful coordination of care team, which means that there may be programs and services that aren't available in the VA or more convenient for the veteran to go to a private provider in the community or nursing home, and we coordinate the care so that the VA follows up and checks on that veteran's progress, make sure he or she's doing okay. That's really important to have an advocate for you as you're seen by a private healthcare provider. Big, huge thing right now across the nation in healthcare and certainly in the VA, and we've got a couple of folks here that can talk to this, but we've got a wonderful program called MOVE. So everything right now is about you as an individual, as a person, to take care of your own physical well-being. And if you're doing that, if we can make sure that you're not being seen by a provider, yeah, we don't want to see you necessarily. If you can do all the right things by eating well, by exercising each day, moderation as far as alcohol and all that, and that means you know you'll never be seen in a hospital and see a day. That's the success story, I think, for all of us, right? So the VA's got wonderful programs at the Greenfield Outpatient Clinic. Seth Moss will come up, Pat LaRiviere, and Dr. Mark Schneider every Tuesday. But that's the big focus right now, is I just had my annual appointment and they told me that I need to cut back on my caffeine, don't put half and half on my coffee anymore so I can get my cholesterol down even more. I went cold turkey this past year on ice cream, so I'm doing better on there. But those are the types of things that they'll work with you on an individual care program. And if you do need to see a nutritionist or you want to avail yourself of having a weight management program, that's there for you. Steve Flynn's here from our homeless veterans program. Big initiative right now, both on the federal and state side, to make sure every veteran has a roof over their heads. 21% decline in the past year, but we still, for homeless veterans in Massachusetts, but we still have, on any given night in the Commonwealth, 1,200 veterans who won't be in a bed with a roof over their head tonight. And that's, to me, a disgrace for our nation, and we all share individual response. Collectively an individual responsibility for that. And there's a number on the screen here, and that's what I'd ask each and every one of you to also know. That's a key number, and if I see a veteran on the street, I'll walk them to, have you served? Yes. Have you called this number? Call this number, and we'll get you help. We have a wonderful program in Northampton and throughout the VA system in New England. 10 case managers, approximately, I think, in Northampton. And Jim Bastian's here. He's our suicide prevention coordinator. another important number to have. And I think just within the last couple of days, the VA launched a new text program that you can text the number. It's 838-255, and now you can text in and get 24/7 a counselor to help you out. And for the vast majority of our veterans, we come back, we're adjusted, maybe need a little bit of help, but for a lot of our veterans, the aftermath of serving time, theater of operations and combat, when things get too much to bear, there's programs and services and folks like Jim that can help you out. And Jim, you want to mention anything about your program?
Just to make a couple of quick comments. There's about 32,000 people annually that take their own lives in this country. The unfortunate aspect of that statistic is that one in five people who take their own life is a United States veteran. So 20% of all the people who are currently taking their own life in this country are U.S. veterans, even though veterans only make up 1% of the general population. So we know that men and women who have been in combat or just, you know, experienced some of the rigors of being in the military can be at high risk. People who are diagnosed with depression are high risk for suicide. People who are diagnosed with PTSD are high risk for suicide. People who have bipolar disorder are high risk for suicide. People who have a substance abuse disorder or a drug addiction are high risk for suicide. People who have TBI are high risk for suicide, and people who experience chronic pain are high risk for suicide. In my role as the suicide prevention coordinator, I work only with the veterans who are experiencing suicide ideation or maybe have made an attempt. And my experience is most of the veterans that find themselves in that situation have three or four of those risk factors. So if you are experiencing some of those risk factors, I strongly encourage you to come on into the VA and talk to us, because we do have services that work, we have services that can help you, and we're there 24/7 to provide that assistance.
Thanks, Jim. Yep. Tom earlier mentioned about the DAV, Disabled American Veterans. There are organizations throughout the Pioneer Valley, American Veterans, VFW American Legion, the DAV, Marine Corps League, Navy League, et cetera. Almost all of them have dedicated national service officers who are schooled and skilled in VA benefits, have gone through the training and are certified to help you as a veteran. And that goes back to the earlier message I had with, it's more than just the VA, it's the communities in Massachusetts, it's the national service organizations too. And they all know what it means to serve, because they served as well. They know what it means to file a claim, the information you need to document your information, and what you need to do for follow-up. So if you don't know who those contacts are in your community, Mark Fitzpatrick, Leo Parent, Charlie Lovin, Greenfield in the Veterans Service Office downtown, or Mark over in Turner's Falls, they can help you out and get you a benefits counselor to help you with any information you need on filing for claims or VA processes. Okay, then a couple other things. The Soldiers Home in Holyoke. Did you know that if you served and you received an honorable discharge that you can receive dental care? A lot of veterans don't know that. I didn't know that when I came back home to Massachusetts. Shoot, if I knew that, I probably could have saved a couple. I didn't know about the time for me, and this is all the things you learn as a veteran. As a returning veteran from Iraq, Afghanistan, I didn't know that I had the OEF, OIF program until Ms. Turner called me a couple of times and said I need to get my butt in to get programs and services. But one thing I didn't know until maybe about 6 months ago is that the Soldiers Home has dental care for any veteran that has served. So that's a wonderful resource. So if you have any questions about dental care or any of the programs they have at the Soldiers Home, just down the road in Holyoke, ask John. Couple of websites I want to point out. MakeTheConnection.net. I know I've shared this with Kevin in the VetNet group. This is another wonderful web resource. You know, most of the web pages for the VA are focused on public outreach and communicating to the public at large. MakeTheConnection.net just started on Veterans Day in 2011. And from this web page, you type in your information, when you served, where you served, male or female, and it'll pull up tailored information for you as a veteran, phone numbers, resources, available programs in our area. So it's a great, it's wonderful, and it's, you know, everything that's there on the tabs and in the toolbar there, life events and experiences. They have now veterans from across the country that are sharing, they get videotaped and they share their experiences, what they've gone through as a veteran, and it's posted on this website from all sorts of different generations. Signs and symptoms, conditions, resources and support. And after this, I have it up on the, I can show you on the screen and we can look at it with anyone that would like to see more on this webpage. But I should point out too, and Sheila helped me out on this, through the Make the Connection page, you can go to something called IRIS. And IRIS is Individual Resources Information System. You know, we're a federal government, so remember your DOD days, or everything's an acronym, right? But IRIS, what IRIS lets you do is, if it's not a VA health question you have, you know, you filed your claim 7 months ago, you want to know what the status is on it. Okay, 2 years ago. Oh. Well, however long ago it was, but instead of, you know, trying to go through a 1-800 number, right, you send them through IRIS your question or complaint or concern, and they'll get back to you. I don't know what the time frame is, if it's within 24 hours, but there's a certain time frame in there where they have to get back to you. It's all tracked, so once you send in your question, comment, complaint, concern, it's tracked, and within five days you have to get an answer back. So that's good, and it's good documentation too for you to have. So if anyone wants to see how that works afterwards, I can show you through that. And then a couple more here. My Healthy Vet, great program, about 5 years now in existence. It keeps its nationally recognized, award-winning program, as far as using a web-based program for you to talk to your medical provider. Prescription refills, questions for your doc, and all can go through My Healthy Vet. And it's got all sorts of other programs and information on wellness, and et cetera. The key thing with My Healthy Vet is that if you go into one of our clinics or in the Northampton Medical Center through primary care, or if you go into the Greenfield Clinic, they'll help you fill out the paperwork and do an on-site individual authentication, so in-person authentication. And that's important because once they verify who you are, photo ID and your VA card or your 214, then you can get into the system and you can have all the resources available to you online to talk to your provider. I mean, I use it, it's great. You know, you just send your doc an email if you have questions about your medication, you know, how often, that kind of thing. You'll get an answer back the next day. So it's a wonderful resource to have. Okay, so we have a table, all sorts of information there as well on My Healthy Vet. Okay, and then without further ado, our goal is to make sure you have every opportunity today to enroll in VA healthcare. If you served, it behooves you to ask questions, get your name on the list, and otherwise, that's all I have, folks. We've got lots of program managers here and specialists to answer your questions. Thank you so much for your service. Thank you to Greenfield Community College and the VetNet Group. You folks are wonderful, and as I mentioned at the beginning, you're leading the way as far as we're concerned with getting information out to our veterans. So kudos to all of you, Diane, Shane, everyone here has just been phenomenal. I'd like to come back anytime. Thanks everyone.